The SpaceX CEO tried to get the spacecraft off the ground but ran into some friction. The idea of a three-letter government agency that stops Elon Musk from doing whatever he wants may seem like a bureaucratic fantasy. This guy got permission to send a Tesla into space, renamed the street Rocketrode, and even changed the business space forever. But Musk's ambitious schedule to launch his dream Starship rocket in a remote area of Texas is now awaiting a delayed FAA decision. That has caused months or even years of delays that could lead to the birth of this particular character. Luckily, SpaceX and Musk finally figured it out the best way to deal with the FAA, and how is he gonna do it exactly? Well, let's find out in today's episode of Science of Space. In recent years, Musk and SpaceX have built space cities around the Gulf of Mexico, bought land, built new facilities, and even posted job ads for spaceport. Musk also moved to a nearby village after being evicted. Some of today's Boca Chica villagers are almost unrecognizable in their pre-Musky appearance. It's a serene seaside paradise, now a bustling space shipyard. They even imagine that Boca Chica Beach will be the gateway to Mars. Since its inception in 2014, Musk has positioned the space station as one of the best places to make history. Perhaps the first people who flew to another planet could take off from here. Musk says it will be a new type of space station optimized for commercial operations. In December 2020, after flying high and crash landing a prototype dubbed SN8, he tweeted thanks for supporting South Texas. The decision, unveiled June 13, after months of delays and debate as the FAA approves an environmental clearance for the company's South Texas base for orbital launches, follows public beaches and wildlife around SpaceX's private spaceport at Boca Chica Beach. Actions to eliminate the impact on a city 20 miles east of Brownsville, Texas, but the decision is still a victory for Elon Musk's space company. It involves launching a larger-than-Saturn V rocket that will take astronauts to the moon. The company will consider 75 new rules, including restrictions on road closures and wildlife corridors, as well as less traditional requirements such as preparing a report on the historical context of the Mexican War, before SpaceX receives the FAA's final mega rocket launch documents. The license only covers more than 10 launches a year, and is limited to 5 sub-orbits and 5 orbits, easily accessible to the company once Starship is flying. Which will delay environmental group lawsuits, litigation and at least one other threat in Texas. Increases. Starship launches are weeks, months, or even more than a year. What is the solution for all this? Musk is known as a trailblazer and has few backup options. SpaceX has expanded its Texas facility, but the company has stepped up its footprint off the coast of Florida. If SpaceX leases the launch pad, and the FAA decides that SpaceX's plans in South Texas need more attention. SpaceX is currently NASA's only option to get astronauts from the United States to the International Space Station, Musk said, moving the Starship program to Florida. Said he would start. The company will build a new launch pad and manufacturing facility in the second quarter of next year, and will initially ship vehicles from the port of Brownsville to the Cape. He said in response to a question on Twitter, specifically when and where. In this episode, Starbase's uncertain future was revealed for the first time at a meeting, hosted on-site under the spacecraft's 400-foot rocket, showing the honorees a simulated video that Musk launches from Boca Chica Beach on February 10 in Texas, bring the red planet. At a public event, Musk warned that the FAA delay could result in the spacecraft's first orbital flight outside of Texas. It will take some time until fall 2022 to get the pad ready for an orbital launch, which is completely over-optimistic, just as Musk had predicted. SpaceX is the Kennedy Space Center and the only launch site for the Crew Dragon capsule. The only spacecraft of its type is currently the only spacecraft capable of sending astronauts to the ISS, and the launch pad is government property, not a test flight. The idea to test a giant booster on the same launch pad put NASA and the Florida Space Force on hold, in light of the explosive results from other early SpaceX tests that could crash Starbase's launch system and more. It is solidly engineered for safer missions, and luckily Musk is a worst-case scenario, as after NASA raised concerns about the threat as the only current site, SpaceX proposed modifying a second Florida launch pad to support the Dragon manned mission. Thought the company, accredited to Dragon, has begun working with the agency on plans to correct HLC-39A's line and nose. Space Force Station Canaveral LC-40 supports Dragon launch. Nothing is known about the type of modification required for the LC-40, but it is likely required by NASA. SpaceX will develop something similar to the Path 39A facility, which will include building a new crew access tower, crew rescue system, and astronaut bunker on site, despite LC-40 being the launch pad for the second Dragon. Then, over time, I think we're going to have floating spaceports like ocean spaceports. We've got these two converted oil rigs that are going to be turned into orbital launch sites, and they can be moved around the world. The two platforms currently being converted are Phobos and Deimos, although very little work has been carried out over recent months. One will gain renewed focus with the installation of its own launch tower by the end of this year. Now, SpaceX 1C launch spaceport Deimos, are already in construction and probably half a work done and just left to install GSE tank and launch tower or other things. That first operational sea launch platform would allow a template to be formed and the purchase or construction of additional platforms, with Musk adding there, could be quite a few of those. I think most of the launch sites long-term will be ocean or sea spaceports, maybe located 20 or 30 miles offshore, and this would allow Starship to connect any cities that are on the ocean or on the sea, and have a high flight rate without disturbing people too much. I think people are willing to have something that's loud occasionally, but if you want to have it frequently, then it needs to be offshore. I think about what would really work for long distance. Because the rocket is quite loud, you want to be, I don't know, 20 miles away from a major city, or 30 miles away from a major city just so you're not disturbing people too much. I think most of the launch sites long-term will be kind of ocean or sea-based ports. Musk said he thinks people would tolerate an occasional noisy launch, but not on a regular basis. The converted rigs, christened Deimos and Phobos after the two moons of Saturn, have been a low priority to date as SpaceX has concentrated on creating a functional launch site at Boca Chica, he said. But the company plans to build at least a catch tower, and at some point full launch capability, on one of the offshore platforms later this year, Musk said. They want to operate Starship just like an airliner, with each vehicle carrying hundreds of passengers and doing multiple flights per day. The platform could conduct dangerous test launches that the Kennedy Space Center could not provide. Musk said sometimes in February. I think it will be a floating space base. Orbital launch pad that is get up and go around the world. The idealist Musk believes that every 2 years, as Earth approaches Mars, 1,000 spacecraft leave Earth and use the Cadence, Texas, Florida platform off the coast, to facilitate humanity's first permanent migration to another planet and location. Red Planet. Thanks for watching this video and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this, to make sure you can subscribe. If you have any crazy idea what we should cover in next video, please comment it below, and we will see if we can get the, and thanks again for watching and goodbye.